There's two things I know for sure. She was sent here from heaven, and she's daddy's little girl.
What Jody's really really worried about, she's really worried that she's gonna that her daughter is gonna like her new stepmom. I already know what's not to like about her. You know what I'm saying? Like, if she ever saw any part of Andy that maybe she didn't like, well, let me tell you what. Very well could have been brought on by the dynamic and the mixture of the ingredients here, right? So I would suggest to Chattanooga, if you're watching this, sweetheart, like, man, give that situation a chance. I feel like your mom is lying, right? Like, I know your mom is lying. But give the situation a chance. You may find that you become the best of friends with Becca. And let me tell you what, Chattanooga, that is okay. It is okay to be friends with your stepmother, because your father chose this woman in a different kind of way than he ever chose your mom. And that is not representative. It's not representative of you. That's what you need to understand. This stuff that's going on right now, sweetheart, this is not your fault. This stuff is not your fault. And a lot of times, kids your age, I know you think you're an adult, you're a kid, sweetie. Kids your age, a lot of times they feel like they're responsible for the parents splitting up. I mean, Chattanooga, a lot of times kids put that on themselves without any outer input. And then other times, the parents can help put that dynamic onto the child and make them feel responsible. Like, well, you know, it's an impossible domestic situation that gets cooked up. And once you get comfortable in that toxicity, you don't know no different. You go to your friend's house and you don't even really have any relative friends like from school that you can go hang out and get a baseline on how other families are. Like, I wish you had five friends, Chattanooga, that you could go see one a week for 5 weeks and come back and then look at your situation. Like, you don't know what you're living in because you're not let out of the box. Your mom is keeping you in a box. Just like she always says your dad did to her. Let me tell you what, sweetie. That may be her opinion, but let me tell you what, sweetie. That's actually what your mom is doing to you right now, is keeping you captive. But most of all, for butterfly kisses after bedtime prayer.